Stay at home, stay safe and healthy. So the next unit, Newton's third law of motion. Everybody knows that. What is Newton's third law of motion? Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Alright. Now, regarding Newton's third law of motion, the most important thing is that you have to identify which one is action and which one is reaction. Alright. So, let us consider this one. Suppose you have kept, this is the book, let us consider. So, suppose there is a book you have kept on the table. Alright. Then you see the weight of the book, it is acting down and it is acting on the table. Isn't it? You have seen this. Just consider instead of book and table. That suppose if you are carrying, just you consider this is a heavy object and you are carrying on your palm. Then you can feel it, no? That you are carrying a heavy object. Why? Because the weight of the object is acting on your palm. So you see, the weight of the object that is acting on your palm, that is action. Alright, acting in the downward direction. So, what your palm will apply an equal and opposite reaction on the heavy object kept on your palm. Isn't it? And that what I call, already you studied in the earlier discussion, and this force is known as the normal reaction. So you see, on your palm, weight of the book is acting, that is action, and you are applying, your palm is applying normal reaction on the object you have kept on the palm. Is that clear? So you understand, action acting on your palm, reaction acting on the object. In this case, action is acting on the table. So you see how I have written. For every example, you have to learn this also for exam purpose. Okay, what is the action here? Weight of the book acting on the table. And what is the reaction here? Normal reaction acting on the book exerted by the table. Clear? So you see, action is acting on the table, reaction is acting on the book. Clear? So, action and reaction act on different bodies. This is the basic concept and most important concept related with the third law of motion. Clear? So, as the two forces acting on different bodies, they cannot cancel each other. Is that clear? Now, you can verify Newton's third law of motion by doing a very simple experiment. You take two spring balances. Alright. So, suppose from a rigid support, you have suspended one spring balance. Then, you join it with another spring balance B. And then, you pull the spring, pull the pointer connected here by your hand in the downward direction. Alright, then what will be your observation? You will observe that both the pointers of both the spring balance, they will come down and both the spring balance will show you the same reading. Alright, you just see here, I have taken one example. So this one is taking showing the reading 6 gram force, and this is also showing the reading 6 gram force, means both of them are showing the same reading. So what is happening? Let us try to understand. So when you are pulling it down, then what is happening to the spring of the spring balance A, the pointer of the spring balance A, spring as well as the pointer, it will come down under the action. Is that clear? So you see, this action is provided on A by B. Clear? So what A will do, A will apply an opposite reaction on the spring balance. So what is happening, you see, the down one, the down spring balance is also showing the same reading, 6 GF. So you see here, action and reaction. By this experiment, you can prove that action and reaction, they are equal and opposite in direction. Now the examples of Newton's third law of motion in our day-to-day life. First one is pushing a wall. Alright. Now remember, understand that all these examples I am discussing one by one. In all the examples, you have to identify the action and reaction force. What is its direction? And you will just learn that only, action and reaction, for every example. And that is important for your board exam. Okay, so first is pushing a wall. So when you are pushing the wall, then you are exerting a force on the wall. Okay, that is action. So you see, I have written what is the action? Force exerted by you on the wall. Then what is the reaction? Wall will exert a force on you. Okay, so the wall is exerting a force on you, that is reaction. So you see, if action is in this direction, reaction is in the opposite direction. So this is the way you must note down in the study material notebook and you must learn it. Then next one is motion of a boat moving away from the shore. You have seen, I hope you have seen, suppose there is a boat, it is on the shore and the boatman wants to take the boat on water. Then what the boatman does generally, I hope everybody has observed that by taking the oar, he does set it on the shore, then push the shore, isn't it? So you see what is happening, the boatman is applying a force by his oar on the shore, got it? That is action. So what the shore will do, will apply an equal and opposite force on the boatman. Clear? So boatman along with the boat, it will move under the action of the, under the force exerted by the shore. So the force exerted by the shore, that is known as the reaction. So what is the action here? Force exerted by the boatman on the shore. And what is the reaction? Force exerted by the shore on the boatman. Is that clear? Now, next example is motion of a boat in water. Means already the boat in water and the boatman is taking the boat in the forward direction. So, I hope you have observed that by the oar, just in this way, they push the water in the backward direction. If you want to move in this direction, forward direction, then you will see the boatman will push the water by the oar in the backward direction. Got it? So what is happening? The force exerted by the boatman with his oar on water in the backward direction, that is action. So what is action here? Force on water exerted by the boatman. So what the water will do? If the boatman push the water in the backward direction, then water will push the boatman in the forward direction. Means water will push the oar along with the boatman, along with the boat in the forward direction. That is reaction. Alright. So what is the reaction? Force on boatman along with the boat exerted by water. Alright. Now here I think, okay, so this is the way you must write down what is the direction of action and reaction for all the examples. Next example is firing a bullet from a gun. Now these three examples from the point of view of exam is very important. These are the most frequently asked questions. Firing a bullet from a gun. So you see, from the gun, when the bullet is coming out, then gun is applying a force on the bullet, that is action. Alright, so what is action here? Force on the bullet exerted by the gun. You will see that when the any person fires a gun, then the person experiences a backward force. Alright, so that is known as the recoiling of a gun. So, what is happening? The bullet will apply a force on the gun in the opposite direction. That is also known as recoil force. Alright? And this is the reaction. So, what is the reaction here? Force on the gun exerted by the bullet. Clear? So, here you see there is a tip. That action and reaction, when you are writing, after writing the action, when you can, how you can write down the reaction? Just interchanging the place of the two objects. Alright, you see here, force on the bullet exerted by the gun. And here what I have written, force on the gun means bullet and gun, they have interchanged their position. Alright, that is a clever way to write it. This one will apply those who cannot handle it physically. Alright, but with proper understanding, if you can do, well and good. Then next one is rocket motion. Now, I hope everybody has seen in the Discovery Channel how the rockets are propelled in the space. Alright, now, in the rocket, you will see there is a nozzle here. Inside the rocket, there are different chambers. And in the lowermost chamber, the gases are there. So, these gases, when these are get burnt within the rocket, then burnt gases are allowed to come out through this fine nozzle in the downward direction. Alright, so you see what the rocket is doing. Rocket is exerting a force on the bond gas in the downward direction, which is the action. So you see what is action? Force on the bond gas exerted by the rocket. So what the bond gas will do? Bond gas, according to Newton's third law of motion, apply the reaction on the rocket, and under the action of the reaction force of this bond gas, the rocket move in the upward direction. So what is the reaction force here? Force exerted by the bond gas on the rocket is the reaction. Clear? Then next example, catching a ball. While catching a ball, that already I have discussed in the earlier section also, that when a cricketer is catching the ball, then cricketer is stopping the ball. Cricketer is applying a force on the ball to stop it. Okay, that is action. So what the ball will do? The ball will apply an opposite force on cricketer's hand. That is the reaction. So what is the action in this case? Force on the ball exerted by the player. And what is the reaction? Force on the player's hand exerted by the ball. Force exerted on the player's hand by the ball is the reaction. Is that clear? So these all, for all these examples, action and reaction, you learn. Next example is working on the ground. Alright, when you work on the ground, then you apply the Newton's third law of motion. Alright, we apply. So understand it. Now, when you work on the floor, this is not a real classroom. I am missing that. So, you see, just consider that my hand is your foot. Okay, so when you walk on the foot, do you walk like this? Means you place the foot like this, or you place your foot like this? Yes or not? Clear or not? You place your foot like this, or you place your foot like this? How you place? You place your foot like this, isn't it? First the toe, this is the toe. Toe touches the ground. So here I'm not expert in the three dimensional drawing, so by a line I'm showing you. Suppose this is your foot and this is the toe. So you place your foot like this, okay, and by this one, you can, by the heel, what you do, you press the ground in this direction. So you see, this is the action. Force exerted by heel on the ground is the action. You first press your foot like this. Heel is touching the ground. You never do like this. Okay, heel is touching the ground first. So by the heel, you are pressing the ground, that is action. So what the ground will do? Ground will exert a force on you, that is reaction. Now, this reaction, you can break it into two components. One is the horizontal component, another is the vertical component. Alright, horizontal component helps you to move in the forward direction, whereas the vertical component, it balances your weight. Alright, so all these things, if you cannot remember, no problem. Just remember what are the action and reaction. So what is the action? Here I have written child, okay, because you are writing that. That's why better to write child instead of man. So what is the action? Force by the child on the ground, that is action. And what is the reaction? Force by the ground on the child. Clear? So you see, when you are working on the ground, you are applying Newton's third law of motion. This example, working on the ground, is also important for your board exam. So I said three examples are important for your board exam. Firing of a bullet from the gun, working on the ground, that is important, and rocket motion. Is that clear? Now, the last example. Motion of a boat away from the shore when somebody is jumping from the boat on the shore. Alright, you can do this next time when you go to Maithan and you are jumping from the boat on the shore. You will see the boat will move in the backward direction when you will jump from the boat on the shore. Why it is happening? When you are jumping from the boat on the shore, then boat is pushing you on the shore. So that is the action. So what you will do? You will apply a force on the boat in the opposite direction. Okay, so that is the reaction. So in this case, what is action? force on the person by the boat is the action. And what is the reaction? Force on the boat by the person.